Hello, hello, everybody. Welcome to Tuesday. How's everyone doing? Wasn't really planning on anything major, so I'm going to go ahead and go into my new DSC boosted tune and wander over to the Barrenlands and start blowing stuff up. Fact is, I could use the marks, and I think, why not? Why not? I hope everyone is having a fantastic Tuesday. My morning was not the best. It kind of snowed here, so I had to get up and shovel some snow. It's always fun. Badlands here. Couldn't take us much longer to get in there. Should have done this before I fired up the stream, but hey. While we're doing that, we can into the Badlands. Let's do this! Looks like they're trying to take over this. Goodbye, Mr. Frigate. Goodbye. The point is secure. Take care of that. Hello, Salty Boo. How's it going?
We are being followed.
Thank you for following, buddy. I appreciate that. All right. Well, I try to make it fun for everybody. Don't always succeed, but, you know, Yeah, so far it's all right. Other than it snowed pretty good last night, so I had to shovel some snow this morning. But
watch out! The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep.
First world problems, right? Come on. There we go. Nebula class, huh? Buddy. You should not bring a Nebula class near.
Rear shields failing. Right shields failing. Target shields have failed.
Oh, they're actually damaging me. Oh, you did not just shoot that laser tachyon beam at me. Buddy, buddy, buddy. Don't be doing that. Oh, I thought I had someone fall on this.
Hull integrity below 50%. Warning, ship is under attack.
Oh, to be what? All right. It's a classic freaking classic song right there, buddy.
Hull integrity below 25%.
Oh. Well, I have to say, personally, I don't think Born to be Wild was his best song. That's just my opinion. I always liked Magic Carpet Ride. But to each their own. To each their own. The wonderful thing about music, everyone has it, is totally entitled to their own opinions on it. No, you might like one song, I might like another one. That's totally fine.
Watch out. Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away from the satellite.
Oh, will it? Okay. Well, it's dead now, so I don't think it's going to do that. I was 16,000. Alright. Alright, he's done. Gas chew bubblegum. Duke Nukem swing zone. Okay. I haven't heard that one in a while. I haven't heard that one in a long while, actually. Mind you, I haven't played Duke Nukem in a while either.
Away from the satellite.
Okay, I guess I should follow the satellite because no one else is doing it. Four people here. One game I'm surprised I haven't recreated was Duke Nukem. I mean, they tried with Doom, didn't work too well. I think they tried with Wolfenstein also, but that also didn't work that well. Yeah, that's on shuffle. Okay. WWE. Oh boy. I used to follow WWE pretty closely, but
that incoming Terra Nebula science vessel will try to push you out of the area.
I can bite the bullet here pretty quick. Yep, that's what I thought. Might help her take the cap off. Yeah, I kind of figured that death was incoming. Ship's still a little bit squishy yet. But also, probably help me too if I stop flying in the plasma cloud. Seems to me likely we we have lost every zone, so we've taken. Okay, that's great. Oh, please! Push me towards your friends. Good idea. Enjoy death. Bunch of frigates.
Watch out.
Four shields failing. Rear shields failing. Right shields failing. Left shields failing. Target shields have failed. All integrity below 75%.
Bye, Nebula. Oh, another one. Fancy you being here. Oh, yeah, more than disintegrated. He got erased. I think at this point I'm just flying around shooting stuff because we've lost pretty much every zone we had in the battle zone, so.
Ship is under attack. Four shields failing. Rear shield failing. Target shield has failed. Left shield failing. All integrity below 50%.
Use the zone for a bit. Let my hull regenerate for a little while and come back. Downside for you, sir, is my hull's regenerated now. Not a good thing for you. Got all three of them. Gotta love torpedoes, man.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel.
Really?
You away from the satellite.
Like, I was gonna leave you alone, but then you had to shoot me. Two frigates. All right. Back out for a bit again. Let my hull regenerate over a little bit again. Fight fire with. Well, that's a good song. That's a good tune, also, buddy. Got a pretty good playlist going there, buddy. Hi, science vessel. How's it going? Not good for you, I think. Back out again.
That incoming Terra Nebula science vessel will try to push you out of the area.
Ship is under attack.
Buddy, why do you have to do that? I was leaving the area.
Four shields failing. Guardian shield has failed.
I mean, you had a chance to not be involved. Something's hitting me hard. Holy crap.
Nebula science vessel incoming. Watch out for repulsor guns.
You know, I think it's the warp course that's killing me. Ooh, all three of them! Ooh.
Four shields failing. Rear shields failing.
Oh, you little bastard. Okay. Time for you to go bye-bye.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away from the satellite.
I'm first to get out of here again. Our hull regen. Well, we're not really accomplishing much as far as the zone is going. However, they are collecting a lot of salvage. R&D material, which is always good. Never really have too much R&D material. Oh, someone else finally come in? Hey, John. Jack Wonder, how's it going, buddy? Welcome to the stream. How are you doing today, sir?
The station's metaphasic shields have dropped. Focus fire on the plasma control station. Shut it down to drop the metaphasic shield.
Ah, it's good to hear, buddy. Good to hear. Okay, I think I saw you. CJ Tomb Raider, how's it going, buddy? Welcome to the stream. Oh, still squishy. I did see you on the Discord. I noticed that, yeah. That is hurt, isn't it? No, it's not. Okay. Okay, just components of the ship. Fine. Moving on. It is the new Miracana, yep. Ymir, Terran Worship. Just picked it up the other day. I bought it off the exchange. I had to sell quite a bit of keys to do it, but got it off the exchange. I think on the exchange on PC was going for, I picked it for 744 million, something around there. The trade alone, in my opinion, is worth it. Well, I'll tell you what, some people do have it listed at a billion. And those people are idiots, in my opinion, because they'll never sell for a billion. It's not worth it at a billion. No ship in this game is worth a billion. The one ship that will probably always remain at 1 billion or 1.5 billion. It's so outdated now that it's not even worth looking at. The traits alright, but there's better traits. There's better science ships than the jellyfish one. the bulk up the bot. The Vulcan experimental science ship is quite outdated, in my opinion, now. And I do apologize for the stream freezing. Twitch has been having a few issues this week. I don't know what it is. Oh, okay. Well, I wonder if that's the problem. Maybe Twitch has set everyone's default to a higher setting or something. I suppose it's possible. Yeah, but the thing is, though, Twitch doesn't operate on 1080p.
The device is in standby mode. Complete the shutdown process.
At least, how did that work again? I think it's for streaming they don't work on. Yeah, that's what I mean, CJ. I think what happened is Twitch change the viewer default from 720 to 1080p. They used to default at 720. I don't know. I'm taking a guess. I do know that a lot of streamers have been noticing that as of late. Actually, I'm going to. There we go. I got my game on my slider and I can actually hear myself talk. I think, are you on a computer or are you on the app? Like on your phone or anything, or I think it depends on what type of device you're connected with. PC? Okay. Like I said, I'm just guessing right now. I do know what other streamers have had some issues with their stream freezing up and all that stuff and buffering, and unfortunately it's one of those things we just kind of have to deal with. And technology, the more it advances, the more it breaks down. Oh, there's a science ship. Hi, science ship. How's your day going? Not so freaking good, I think. Hi, how's it going, buddy? I'm assuming you're just getting home from work.
We are being followed.
CJ, thank you for the follow. Very much appreciated, buddy. Very much appreciated. Oh, just started at work. Oh, okay. Actually, that would make sense. You're on the other side of the world for me, so that makes sense. Oh, I see. I see. Night shift. Those are always brutal, aren't they? Oh, sounds good, CJ. CJ. DJ, CJ, CJ. Flying in a giant pancake flipper, are you? I always nicknamed that ship the giant pancake flipper. Fair enough, buddy. I always felt it was too big. Three frigates, one shot. Oh yeah. Oh, I don't know about that. I think there is definitely a... Too big is definitely a thing that can happen. You know what, Mr. Frigate? It is definitely a thing. Well, okay. That is true. However, the both ships that we can fly aren't bad. I think I see you. The USS Universe. That makes sense. It is a Universe class. I don't think we can fly the Citadel ships. Those are freaking huge. Mind you, so is the Zindi aquatic. Or carrier or whatever that is. Torpedoes. All right. It came from behind. Yeah. Close. Don't think we're gonna have enough time to get in Parknor. Goodbye, frigates.
Disable the power station that's orbiting the base. Shut down the portal generators to force them to switch to emergency power.
All right. First things first. What does that emote say there, Pi? Let's go? Okay. Let's go! Let's go, let's go, let's
go! Destroy the plasma control station and deactivate its auxiliary satellite.
Oh, come
on. Warning.
Let's go! Goodbye, frigates. Oh, it's surrounded by fire, is it? Okay. Bye. Oh, I think we have time to get Parknor, but looks like the other group's getting at it. Hang on. Aw, oh, he runs away. Oh, he ran away. Right there. Okay, you can die. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, we got them all. All right.
Excellent work.
All right, return to home base.
Sensors reading a large force of Terran ships inbound. They must be making a final push. All ships assemble to present a united front against the Terran forces.
A united front! Watch, it'll be like three ships. Yeah, it's pretty much just, well, there's me and him, one guy. This could be bad. Yeah, this might be the roughest version of this I've ever experienced.
This is Admiral Leeta.
Yeah, Leeta, shut up.
The ISS Enterprise. I am taking charge of this operation. Alright,
I think we got this, CJ. I think we got this. Reasons 1 and 3 are enough alone, to be honest with you, CJ. The fact that it cost you that much, yeah, that's worth thinking it. Okay, you're dead. All right, moving on. I think this is definitely going to be the roughest patch of this particular invasion I've ever experienced. Usually this place is like just swarming with people afterwards. That would be easier because now they just send the frigates in, but... Infuse me all you want, but don't get between me and the blood wine! Aww, the Enterprise blew up. Oh, well. The other Enterprise, Alright. Things are dead. How is he tracking me when he's dead? It's better. Oh, maybe it was one of these stupid platforms that got me. That might have been it. Congratulations, you've just been erased. From time. Been pushed back.
The Mirror Universe invaders will take a little time to regroup before they come back.
All right. I'll fly myself into the safe zone and take a little bit of a break. I want some water. Yeah, that was pretty much all us. Just you and me. I don't think anyone else is in the zone. Which I think is rather odd, because like usually there's like tons of people in there. But anyways, guys, I'm going to take a quick little like 2-minute break here and just go grab some water and be right back. So stay tuned. And find my intermission screen. That'll work. Alrighty. I think I'm back. And catch up my chat here. I think I'm back.
A new wave of Mirror Universe ships is coming through.
I always have to say that because every once in a while, if I jump between Streamlabs and game, sometimes my game freezes up. So I gotta, just in case I'm not actually back. You see my face? We can change that, my friend. We can change that. I have the technology. Oh, I didn't get on wall. Okay, fine. Snapcam? No, this is my webcam.
The device is active. Stay within 3 kilometers to start shutting it down.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Right shield failing. Four shields failing. Rear shields failing.
Okay, you want me away from it? Okay. I'll back off for a while. Don't worry, no problem. All right, get ready. Oh, okay, I never thought of that. Yeah, but I think I need a green screen for that, though, don't I? And I kind of sort of have one with my fake one here. Oh, it's my lamp that's showing up behind me. Okay. Oh, okay. I don't think I need to do that. I think my face is ugly enough there, Pi. I don't need to hide it anymore. But eventually I do want to get a green screen behind me. An actual green screen. Okay, I'll go away again. That's what's behind me, though. Oh, Pi. Doesn't work. Fine, because my lighting is crap in this room, too. But if I get the, on Amazon, I saw there's a package you get with that. It has the green screen and the appropriate lighting to go with it. Eventually I'll go and grab that, but no, I tried the bedsheet thing behind me. It works as a background, but the filter doesn't take it away. Whew, that was a lot of big numbers. Hi, science ship. I think Terran Goodbye just activated. I'm all alone this one particularly. I know CJ was here earlier, but I think he's in another zone or something. Another area. You ask and someone shows up. Look at that. Okay, Frigates. You're starting to piss me off. You're not dying like I want you to, okay? Okay, let's get away from their explosions. That hurt. A dark zone was on. I definitely do see Darkthorn as Arn, so that's one thing. Probably playing as KDF though. Why'd you leave this circle, Mr. Bird of Prey? Come on now. If I shut down, should be half complete soon. Oh. Hi, Nebula class science ship. Hi, torpedoes. I think those torpedoes hurted him. Okay, Nebula. Oh, I was leaving you alone. I was leaving you well enough alone. Oh, well, that saved someone? Okay, fair enough. I figured you were still here. Honk the horn! Meep meep! The best horn you're getting, buddy. Four people? We got this, man. We totally got it. Totally got this, buddy. Oh, I can't. I may not give you a horn, but I can give you this. If it works.
You motherfuckers are gonna kill all my lilies!
There, does that count as your horn there, Pi? You probably got some people attention at work for you. I'm not grinding, I just wanted to blow stuff up for a while, that was all. But I mean, if I get some marks, well, I'm at it, why not? Why not? I think it's gone up quite a bit today. Ooh, someone's hitting me hard. Well, that escort. That escort's kicking my ass. Hang on. Here. Need a torpedo for 74,000 damage, you jerk. I haven't looked at the exchange today.
Device shut down, 2/3 complete.
478 to buy, 477 to sell. It's gone down a little bit. Gone down 3 points. And with them announcing 2 bundles. I will bet before the weekend it goes back up. They announced a Lobby bundle and a new Mods Market bundle. Neither one I'm going to bother getting, but... Yeah, the Lobby one, and they got another one for a Dreadnought bundle in the Muds Market, in the Zen store. It's similar to the other two they've released, where they got 3 ships and then the keys and tech upgrades, etc. Same idea. But none of the ships are worth it, in my opinion. It's 3 Dreadnoughts. It's the... Tholian, The Herc one and the Paradox. Which the Paradox, in my opinion, is outdated. It's, you know, that was one of the first temporal ships they put into the game, so it's like, yeah. They put it, like they put that one into the game before there was temporal seating. So it's a temporal ship without temporal seating. So it's like, yeah, no thanks. Which pack did you get there, Pi? There's seriously no one on the satellite again? Okay. No problem. I got a new chair too. I would say probably the Atlas there, Pi. That console is pretty handy. That DPRM is on that Atlas, and that one is quite sought after by a lot of the DPS guys. I definitely need to get some better shields for this goon. Revolutionary shed is not that great. Remember what the D9 has for the zone, yay! Ooh, a purple thing to salvage. Battery. Yay for batteries! Prototype Dreadnought Cruiser. D9 Dreadnought. You may want to look up the prototype Dreadnought and see how much is going on the exchange. Because that might be a really good EC thing for you, buddy. He said it's one of the most sought after ships in the, a lot of the DPS guys. Yeah. Not sure how you got a hold of that one. Damn. Oh, nice. Okay. Yeah, I know it's in the Affinity prize pack, on the Affinity boxes now, but. Yeah, my stack of Infinity boxes in my account bank is very fastly increasing again. I had over 1,000 in there at one point. And I think I'm up to like 3,000 now. Did my camera get bumped?
Two generators offline, one to go.
Fair enough. Oh, nice, nice. Yeah, I went full torp build on this building. Took Augie's build and put it on one of my ships. Stop them! Alright, I will. Oh, one ship. Off my screen! Hell of them with reload. Oh, that would be, yeah, that'd be nice. Up your reload timer. Not even going for. Or in 20 minutes. Well, this is another one I gotta follow, isn't it?
Watch out. The device is active.
You know, buddy, you may not want to keep tractor beaming me. I don't like being tractor beamed. Have a lovely day. A funny voice. A funny voice.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away from the satellite.
Oh, crikey! Blew them all to hell! I think that's my problem. I'm getting too close to the warp core explosions.
You motherfuckers are gonna kill all my lilies!
There. I kinda screwed up the funny voice thing, so I'll play you the little soundtrack. Oh.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away from the satellite.
All right. Did the chat die or
incoming. Watch out for repulsor beams.
Do I need to send out search parties for you guys or you guys okay? Houston has died. Well, shucks.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away.
Yeah, I'm not sending a search priority to your neck of the world there, Houston. It's way too expensive. Sorry. You're nomming dinner. Okay, fine. That's fine. That's fair. Danish. Well, I can tell you one thing, Pi. I couldn't tell if it was Danish or Swedish, buddy. I mean, it's the same language anyways, right? Oh, sure it is. You're right next to each other. I mean, it's the same language. Oh, come on now. The Swedish can't read. Mind you, neither can half the Americans that, you know, live just south of me either, but hey.
Watch out for repulsor warnings. Ship is under attack.
Although at least this year they learned how to vote properly. Did I say that out loud? Yeah, I think I said that out loud, didn't I? Oops. Wardrobe. Hi, it's a wardrobe.
All integrity below 75 shields have failed.
Yeah, I mean, the actual difference between a closet and a wardrobe is the closet usually like in the wall, whereas the wardrobe isn't. That's what it is. I mean, it's literally the same thing. Same function, anyways. Why do you guys always spawn behind me? There. No, we woke the bot up. Bot's awake now. Well, no, wardrobe stands alone, like here. Yeah, I know. Okay. All right. Fair enough. Okay, this is not working. Not with one person, anyways. Low Life Cat, how's it going? Did I pronounce that right? The Low Life Cat? I probably butchered the hell out of that. If I did, I apologize.
Warning. Ship is under attack. Four shields failing.
Okay. They gave me another science to hustle to play with? Oh, look at that. It's not bad right now. This morning kind of sucked. I had to shovel some snow. Hey, Vaughn. Butchering names is what I do, man. Yeah, I know. I want to say that up here too, but unfortunately, it's here. It has arrived and it's here, unfortunately. And apparently I'm dead. Okay. The mirror warship can only take so much punishment. I live up in Canada. Alberta, to be exact. So, that word is kind of expected this time of year, but I still hate shoveling it. Yeah, eh? This is, it's, yeah. Well, you know, some meals, the bowl is actually tasty too, you know. Just saying. You know, if it was soup, whatever, like a bread bowl, it's not bad. This does not work with one person doing this. Oh, they got places up here that do they do the Uber Eats or whatever, they do the soups and soups and stews and bread bowls. Oh, good beef stew and a bread bowl. Oh man, I'm there. I am there. Oh, bot's woken up again. Yeah, it's just a long time when you have to leave the circle every once in a while. Take care of those guys. Well, that sounds like things are improving for you there. On. That's good to hear. Well, with my Jemadar, I can throw to gravel and just follow the satellite, and my gravel does all the work, but. Device shut down, one third complete. Alright, I think CJ's got that. Wreck a few frigates. I saw you on Blossom the other day. I think it was just Sunday, I think. Sunday or Saturday? Oh, you got the Vanguard carrier, eh? Okay.
Nebula science vessel incoming. Watch out
for the one that looks like Smoke's Star Destroyer. Oh, are you still going after your how many pets you can have on the map type thing, or that's still your goal? Nebula class science vessel, huh? The Enterprise J performing the Lorca maneuver. Wow. Do you have all the devices to help you? These those technically count as pets. I wasn't complaining too much. It was just the size of the vessel doing the Lorca maneuver is kind of interesting. Correct.
Watch out. The Terra Nebula class science vessel will use repulsors to keep you away from the satellite.
A 130 pets? Holy crap. What Nebula class? Oh, that one. Okay. Yeah, though, Lucian, it doesn't always summon it, though. There's a chance to summon them, yeah.
Device shut down completely.
This doesn't always happen, though. Like, that's the point I'm trying to make there.
Congratulations, Admiral.
Ooh, I got a spec point. Woo-hoo. Try luck with another section. Yeah, that's a pretty good set. I use it on my my Jem'Hadar.
Generator down. Two more remain.
Not sure how you got the USS Discovery name, but okay. Gotta love that deadly radiation. I noticed that, yeah. more batteries and junk to salvage. Yeah, but why would you want to take them? Carry Kobayashi Maru, like, honestly. Like, not even the Kobayashi Maru wants to be on the Kobayashi Maru. Like, come on. Goodbye. Frigates. Oh, yeah, sure. Hang on. I think I got you on my friends list. Have anything not gold on this?
Warning. Ship is under attack.
Yep, everything's gold. My. Okay, Mr. Inventor, Mr. Frigates, you wanna. I do have to get a better shield, though. I think it sucks. I also have to stay away from their toes. Hi, Frost. Bye, Frost. Strategic Explorer. No, you don't get to live anymore. Swarm incoming! He's bringing the shwarmy! But is he bringing shwarma? That's what I want. I just love it how they take like 20 years to blow up sometimes.
The device is out.
Great.
Stay within 3 kilometers to start shutting it down.
Since we are Team Devon, my natural choice for need or greed is to go need and just let it happen. So, there's an item you want, say something, or roll need on it. Well, for the most part, I've been picking up batteries, so All right. Oh, stuff up. Hey, look, it's smoke. I still think that looks like smoke Star Destroyer. But I can't say too much because I bought it too, so. I haven't used it on anyone yet. Okay, Mr. Science Vessel. I'm gonna make this personal here in a second here, because this is getting annoying. Being behind me and all, so. Enjoy your torpedoes. All right, do this around. All on the station, all right. I'm gonna shoot torpedoes at people. Was that? Thing looks freaking awesome, just saying, but what the hell was it? Thank you. Yeah, the fireball face thing. That was kind of cool. I'm assuming that was one of your consoles. Okay. Yeah, the facing kind of reminded me of the dragon fireworks from Lord of the Rings. Kind of cool. You are starting to piss me off. Goddamn repulsor beam. Next. How many zones we got? Holy crap, yeah, we barely even scratched it. It's alright. The vision I'm getting from this Vaughn is just wrong. I'm just saying.
Thank you.
offline, but enemy ships are crossing through to protect the rift. Stop them!
How dare you cross the rift! Can go sit behind this rock for a quick minute and I will be right back. Partially, I'm on my old man bladder today, so I'll be right back, guys. Alright, I'm back. There we go. Okay. I don't believe I was half embedded in the rock when I left, but alright. Oh, you didn't have to wait for me. Your wingman was in my way, though. Just saying. Oh, I'm sorry, Vaughn. I have no control over what ads they play. I just, I play them mostly because if you play them in during your stream, the ones at the beginning when people come into the stream don't play, is what I've been told. Yeah, I suppose in that situation, it'd definitely keep you on your freaking toes. Hold it. Archer Chase with the raid. Welcome, guys. Welcome. How's it going? How was your stream there, Archer?
We are being followed.
Thank you for following. I appreciate it, buddy. Welcome to the stream. Everybody done. Ah, so far so good. I just fired everything up and decided to go blow stuff up for a while in the Badlands, and I haven't left yet. Feel free to come along, buddy. Doesn't seem to be too many people doing the battle zone today, but yeah, I like this one in the Zenkithi one. Oh, I see a Sov in the strike group chat. Don't like him? Okay, well, take your own. Yeah, the Dyson one is, I used to like it when it first came out, when it was actually difficult. Now it is boring. The only other one I don't like is the Gamma Quadrant one, because that, the way they did it was just weird. That's all I can say. It was just weird. I most like the Zenkithi one for the mechanics of it all, moving the asteroid and all that stuff, but lots of other problem, Para. It's usually bugged. For the most part, it's usually bugged or broken or somewhere in between. Like I said, it's just weird. It's just a weird mechanic. I would have much preferred if they did something like the Badlands or Undyne or something where they just make its own individual zone and well, the thing about all the bugs, though, is they It is taking a while for them to do it, but they are slowly fixing the bugs that they can fix. Like I said, it's taking them a while. It's taking them a long while to fix a lot of them, but... And of course, this year with the, the pandemic didn't really help them at all, because everything got slowed down. Like, literally everything slowed down. Or I should say the plague, because, you know... I don't know why are you shooting your weapons, Vaughn? Yes, that is true, Pi. Yeah, I am liking the new Civil War stuff. That's kind of cool. Ooh, sub a 390 endeavor points. Nice. Our ranks. Nice job, sub. Yeah. Took him a while for the loadouts. Took him a while for just the salvage all button. That was... Oh. No. I will say, before the salvage all button, I never bothered trying to farm salvage because it took hours to salvage everything. It took longer to salvage it than it did to farm the crap to salvage. End up just selling it to a vendor and meh. I'll get salvage when I actually need salvage now. Actually, they might have fixed that. A pair up, because on this tune, my DSC tune here, the away team I'm using are standard Starfleet officers, and they all have the DSC beam out. Or the Discovery beam out. So they might have fixed that. Yeah, it's true. Oh, it's the mission NPC. I see what you're saying. Okay. Curious if that'll work with my, I suppose it depends, too, if the story is written so that they're beaming from, they say, their Romulan ship or something. That's a little different, I guess, but... For most of the part, that's not the case, unfortunately. No, I know that, but I mean, if you had like a Romulan NPC written in the story of the mission, right, so that he beams from his Romulan ship, And it kind of makes sense. But, anyways. Soki-san, thank you for the follow. It's very much appreciated. And welcome. No, I understand that. Yeah, I understand what you're saying there, Para. I'm just saying, if they rewrote that mission and had it her beam in from her ship, it would kind of make sense in that sense, right? But I hear what you're saying. When they have it written, that's that she beams to your ship, yeah. But.
That incoming Terra Nebula science vessel will try to push you out of the area.
Yeah, and I'm certain, Archer, that it has something to do with, as long as they're Starfleet officers, they'll probably use the same animation. Although I haven't tried that with my, Romulan officers from the embassy yet, so... Have to see. Yeah, that's... Yeah. Although my Disco Tactical Officer does get Disco Security Officers. It looks weird, but... Torpedoes. Yeah, some of the small details, I'm hoping they'll be able to work something out in time, but I can kind of see them looking at the code and going, oh my god, what are we getting involved in? And then just, nope, never mind, we'll leave it as it is. Because it might break something else that do we want to really tug on this string to fix, you know, cause that issue?
The device is in standby mode. Complete the shutdown process. Device shutdown complete. Excellent.
Yay, we won! Are they the only ones in the Badlands right now? Six people. Yeah, just you, me, and four others, Zervon. It. Oh, a chimera. Not anymore. This is true. That is a very good point. That is a very good point. You often don't appreciate it until it's gone. That includes old games too. I used to love a game called Dark Ages of Camelot many years ago. Good old Dayok, yep. That was a fun game. Yeah, I used to play on the, we called it the Care Bear server because it was straight PvE, but Gaharis or whatever you can call it. I think I had one of everything. I remember grinding up a bone dancer to level 50, and literally the second I got it to 50, I shelved it. Never got on it again. It was just done. Yeah, I got all the expansions still. The discs I got in the closet somewhere. But if I, if I wanted to go play the game again, because it's not free to play still, but apparently you have to start the account all over. So in order to play, for me to play again, or for us to play again, we'd have to start all over from scratch. That's what I heard. EA kind of screwed that up. But. I don't know. I've never tried with the old keys, but it's EA changed how the accounts worked, or something like that. So like, in order to get on the game now, you have to convert your old account to the EA account, and from what I understand from people I still talk to from there, it deletes all your characters from zero. Like, it just, you're back to day one again. It's just, no thanks. I worked too hard on those characters just to give them up like that. Yeah, bot, I know. This is why the bot doesn't have moderator duty anymore. Okay, that's interesting. All right, Archer, thanks for joining. Thanks for the raid, buddy. I appreciate that. And, yeah, come back anytime you want. And enjoy the rest of your night, man. Imagine any too many people would be playing that game anymore though. Yeah, that's true. And if I recall, that engine was very similar to EverQuest too, wasn't it? Oh, you're fine, Ron. You're fine. It was a good engine, but for games back in the day, his job. I still can't imagine anybody playing the Dark Ages of Camelot anymore. Mostly because of the EA name. EA tends to chase people away from their games for some reason. I think I should change my chat rules. Point. Yep. It's funny how that works, 'cause like think you'd want a game to be sponsored by a big name like EA so that you know your game is going to be funded. You know what I mean? But then again, EA has some really dumb ideas about free to play too. But hey. Ow! Damn, the escort's beating the crap out of me. Okay, come here. Yeah. That is the unfortunate side of the business, right?
The generators are offline, but enemy ships are crossing through to protect the rim. Stop them!
See, I will ask one thing about Call of Duty games. Do they actually break the records, or is that just the company like EA saying it breaks their own records? The reason I'm asking this is because they EA says that every single year with the next NHL game, right? The next NFL Madden or whatever the hell they put out now. I haven't followed sports games in a while, so I couldn't tell you. But it almost seems like every commercial, oh, this is the best game ever we've ever made and blah, blah, blah. And it's like same slogan every year after year. True. It still makes me wonder, though, if they're actually beating their numbers, if they're not, like, just matching the numbers, but... You see that with car manufacturers all the time, too. Oh, this is the safest car in 2020. Built the same way as the 2019 model, so, I mean... No, yeah, that's point, I guess. No. But I'm not saying it's not possible. I'm just curious what. I suppose you would need like third party like numbers to figure that out, because you wouldn't be able to trust the actual company to release honest numbers, I suppose. That is still growth, you're right, yeah. That's a good point. And don't get me wrong, I'm sure EA every once in a while puts out a great version of Call of Duty or NHL or Madden or whatever, but I don't I mean, I call it BS, but I still question it. You know what I mean? Like, it's... You know? Yeah, it kind of depends if you can find an honestly unbiased person to run the statistics. Good luck finding that, but it's about what you would probably need. Hair. It's a good point. Yeah, that's a very true statement. And they always say, like, you know, like 85% of statistics are made up on the spot. I respect that opinion. I do. And the only reason I'm slightly disagreeing with you is because there are 9 billion people in the world. Right, just based on those numbers alone, there's bound to be, or at least there should be, at least one person. It also depends on the subject that you're running the statistics for. If it's something that matters to that person or not. We've secured this point. Why are we driving and flying in circles for? Okay. I'm flying in the wrong direction. There we go. Okay, we'll go after this one. I was paying attention to the chat, Vaughn. That's my excuse. I mean, if you think about the numbers. With 9 billion people on the planet, or however many people on the planet, there's got to be one person that would be able to do it. You know what I mean? I get stuck in their shield. I did. I stayed there. Well, that's fine. You don't have to agree with me. But by the same right, I don't have to agree with you either. And we can have a conversation about it. We just have a straight up discussion. Oh, it is. Oh, that's fair. That's fair, buddy. Well, that's the great thing about having just conversations and discussions, and no one has to agree with anything. Just talk it, you know, conversation. No, that's fair. All I will say that is I am not one of those people who will unfriend or unfollow someone who disagrees with me. No. I see it all the time on like social media where it's like, oh, you don't agree with this? Like, I can't be friends with you anymore. What? Like, huh? You can have a disagreement with people, you know? It's not so much disagreeing that makes the world go. I think it's the debate itself that makes the world go around. And to have a good debate, you need people agreeing or disagreeing with you. No? I won't get into the problems with social media. If it didn't make communicating with my actual my extended family a lot easier, I wouldn't be on social media. I have a Twitter account for this, for streaming and all that, so that people can keep updated. But other than those two reasons, I wouldn't have it. I wouldn't have it. I still can't believe the amount of hatred that gets spread over social media. Unfortunately, because of my previous job, that the smartphone thing I have to have. I shouldn't say I had to have it. But having a smartphone was a lot easier to find addresses and stuff. Yeah. Sometimes it's nice to just not be connected to something. I used to love going out to my grandpa's cabin for that reason, because there was the only, like, there was cell coverage, but the only number you could call well enough was 911. That's it. And then honestly, that's all you really need, for the most part. Oh, come on.
All three bases have been forced back. Excellent work. Sensors reading a large force of Terran ships inbound. They must be.
Well, I will say, Vaughn, your situation and knowing your situation, your situation's a little different. I remember correctly, I'm thinking of someone else. Never mind that. Not at the same time. They cycle through. Yeah, sorry about that, Vaughn. I got one friend where her only communication is to the outside world right now is through like social media and the internet and stuff like that. So.
Yeah.
We're starting to lag. No, the front torpedoes actually cycle. They're firing left from left to right. I have seen it fire once in a while, the dark matter, so. Doesn't fire as often as I would probably like it to, but. And once in a while, it does fire, but it's mostly when I sit still. My one problem with a torpedo build is I like to move around the map. I don't like parking my ship. It bugs me. I don't know. I will for like if I'm shooting at the station or whatever. But and that's probably what's mostly screwing up my. Yeah, because it did fire. Doesn't always disintegrate a target, don't it? Yeah, I know, but I like this mirror warship. Originally, I was going to do it with the Walker class, but in my opinion, I think the Walker class is a little too slow for my playstyle. Even with the competitive engines. I used the legendary crossfield in my science build for a while, and it was a nice ship. Don't get me wrong, it was nice. But for an EPG build, the playstyle for me was a little bit different, I guess. But oh, I'm gonna bite the bullet here, I think. I am losing mega frame, aren't I? No warnings yet. Definitely dropping frames though. Not bad. That's pretty good. I know that isn't like, you know, Augie's level and all that stuff, but I mean, hey, you know what? 150 is not that bad. Pretty good. I think I clocked my EPG build at like 95k, but I was happy with it. It's high enough that I can still contribute to my group. Anywhere I go, so enough for me. Well, I think your current build with your pets would be parsed a little differently because of the pets. And what I mean by that, Vaughn, is your DPS might be a little higher than you think. Yay, we pushed them back.
The Mirror Universe invaders will take a little time to regroup before they come back.
I'm was thinking about changing this ship to a cannon build, but we'll see. All right. Exit the Badlands for this one, because I'm going to call it a stream here. I've been up for 3 hours here. Quack, quack, the Mighty Ducks are in town. Oh boy. So, let us go ahead and see who is online to go raid. Oh, gotcha. Let's go raid the Dark Mom Consortium for the night. Everyone here, thanks for joining me. I pray well, you're much appreciated. If, yeah, so until next time, guys, keep, on trucking, keep on gaming. I'll see you next time. Till then, wear your masks, be safe.